Show you them. She sent a friend. We're live. Welcome everyone. It's Pitch Black here and we've got a lioness right next to us hunting impala. She's very close to them already. Now you can just make her out, and we have the most incredible kit out with us tonight. We have our thermal camera, our FLIR. And there we go, you can see the FLIR, you can see the lioness in the grass, you can see the impala just to the right of her. And you can see that they're unawares. Now we found her walking down the road. She was very hungry. And remember, this is 100% live from Kenya in the Masai Mara National Reserve. We're in the Mara Triangle at the moment with a member of the Magoro Pride. Isn't this absolutely incredible? Oh, I nearly forgot. My name is Brent Leo Smith and I have the incredible VM operating not one, but two cameras simultaneously, including this incredible new tool, the FLIR. Now, of course, it looks like we're on an alien landscape, but isn't that cool? You can definitely see the impala, you can see the lion. It's a windy night, and that's a good for the lion at least. Now, if you want to ask me any questions, just pop them on the feed below. I would love to hear from you. You can see she's just waiting patiently for her chance. She's been snuck there. You can just make her out in the infrared lights, and she's very well hidden in the grass. Now, isn't that incredible? You just saw how that thermal camera gave us the option to be able to see pretty much in the pitch black through the grass. This is very, very exciting. Now, of course, one must remember that, well, before the migration arrives here, the majority of the lion hunts are going to end in not success. So they only have about a 12 or 13% success rate. Now, I wonder if those impala, I don't think they're going to move. They find themselves a nice open spot to keep themselves safe in. There they are. But they're definitely not aware of her presence. And I know a lot of you probably think these new fun toys are very cool. Indeed they are. They are absolutely amazing. There we go. You can just see her in the long grass there now. This is so exciting. I can hear another lion roaring, probably behind where they are. And there's that line of trees in the distance, and you can just, there is a line of trees in the distance. And there could be more lions there. Now she's looking to the right. It's quite difficult to catch where the sound is coming from. I actually think it is coming from the right, from around the river. And you can see. Hi, Shamsung. Shamsung's wondering how far away from camp are we. We didn't actually get that far. As the crow flies, I'm probably less than 5 or 6 kilometers. So we're down on the edge of the Mara River. We were heading down towards Chumvia Kwanza, which is the first salt lick. And there's reports of the western herd coming into that area. And we were going to see if we could find some lions around that first Salt Lick to see if we got any luck around the migration. But while we were happily trundling down the road, we found a very hungry lioness. So I like hungry lionesses, so we decided to stick with her. Now the wind is coming from the impala towards her. And you can see how well camouflaged she is in that long grass. As impala are very close. Now it's going to be interesting to see where she goes from here. And it is a very, it's a very windy night, so she might be able to get very close before they realize. It's also an extremely dark night. There is almost zero ambient light around. Now, I know a lot of you are chatting about how cool the thermal is. It is very, very cool. It's going to change the way we operate at night. Might be able to hear that wind. It's going to be interesting to see if she takes advantage of it. Of course, oh look, her ears are up. You can see her muscles are just probably bunched, ready to explode out of that long grass. There's an impala moving. You can see the impala moving on the thermal cam, on the FLIR. And are they going to inadvertently move into a position that's better for her to spring? Yeah, you can see her there. You can see the ears. You can almost see those muscles balled up with potential energy. Now, let's have a quick look to what she's going to get up to now. Now, I'm sitting in the complete pitch black and I'm relying on the infrared and thermal cameras to be my eyes. Now she's playing the patience game, so even though the impala are probably not going to move too much from that nice safe open area, they might move a little bit. Now there was a lion calling off to the right, so we're just going to sweep off her very, very quickly and have a look off to the right of me to the tree line. Let's have a look if we can spot something in the thermal cam. Are those more lions in the distance there? No, there's a giraffe. There's a giraffe. Okay, so the lion might be in the trees. And, oh, there we go. Oh, wait. What's that on the other side of the impala, Vim? Look there. Could that possibly be the other lion that we heard calling? It's difficult to say. It might be a bit far away. What do you think, Vim?
I can't say either.
Oh, this is too exciting. We don't know what it is. We definitely know it is something that is alive. As I said, I heard another lion calling off to the right of this one. Could we be seeing the classic ambush about to happen? Now, of course, those impala, if that is another lion behind, would be chased directly into the lioness that's next to us. What I am going to do for you then, I know I'm just going to get us on flat ground so we don't have our lights getting into the shot on the thermal cam. So just bear with me for 30 seconds. Not even 4 seconds. Say when, Vimpy. Is that better? Okay. There we go. I'm just trying to get Vim on some even ground. lioness is really well hidden. She's just to the right of that termite mound, yeah? That means have a look. And just come wide a bit again. I'm trying to figure, no, she's in, yeah, she's in that hole there. That's where she is. Now, I'm judging that from where the thermal cam is, and I'm seeing the cool spots and hot spots in the thickets of grass. Okay, let's go a little bit to the right. Let's see if that other thing is still coming behind the impala herd. Was it moving away? Okay, we're back on the thermal cam. You can see, what is that behind there? Ah, I think it's a hippo, maybe?
No.
I think it's a hippo. It's not another lion. I got a bit excited there. I think it's a hippopotamus in the distance. Let's see if our lioness has moved at all. She's moved a tiny, tiny bit forward. There she is. She's really being very patient. She's very good. What she might be doing is waiting for all the impala to lie down, and that'll give her a better chance. Ooh, she looks like she wants. Look, there's a mouse. Look, stay on the line. She's good. Look at that. Hello, mouse. It's a little mouse. But we're going to stick, I think she looks like she's getting ready to maybe try move a bit further and maybe even try an attempt on those impala. Now remember, everyone, this is 100% live from the Mara Triangle in Kenya. He says, how on earth are we supposed to work with all these temptations? Oh, look at the mouse go. Well, I don't know. Of course, this is work, and I'm very lucky I get to do this as work every day. Off you go, little one. Okay, does it look like all three impala have laid down? Now she might think about making a move now. So the impala have all moved down. Hi, Avery. Avery's wondering, where's the great migration? Well, not too far from here. Jamie is actually sitting amongst them at the moment near Lookout Hill, and we were going to look for the Western Corridor herd before we got sidetracked by this lioness who was very hungry. I think she's... Kristen is wondering, would the lion kill that mouse if it came too close? Well, very unlikely. If there were cubs, almost certainly they would have a chase at it, but I think the mouse would be too quick, even for the lions. Now there, she's right in that lovely patch of long grass, which of course is ideal while she's trying to sneak up on some impala. Now I think what's happened now is she's got to a stage now where she's right at the edge of the long grass, and between her and the impala is very, very short grass, and she's close, but she might not just be close enough. She might be just waiting for them to settle. There we go, three looks like young impala boys. And there's the mouse. There we go. Hello, little one. So, a little bit to the left, Vimpy. So she's there. There we go. That's about exactly where she is. And even with the infrared, she is invisible to us. And the only reason we know exactly where she is because of this incredible FLIR that is giving us these amazing images. Sarah is wondering, is she one of the lionesses with cubs? Sarah, I'm not sure. I haven't actually spent much time with the Mogoro Pride recently. Scott's been spending quite a bit of time with them. But as far as I know, none of the Mogoros have cubs. I haven't seen any suckle marks on them. And I have seen them mating. Well, that was quite a while ago. That was probably over a month and a half ago now. I saw them mating with one of the musketeers. Jerry. Jerry would like to know, is this lioness on her own? Yes, she is. Oh, there's another mouse. Another two mice chasing each other in front of the impala. There we go. Where'd they go? Oh, fast mice. There it is. Two of them running around in between the impala and the lioness. Okay, I'm just going to... Her ears are up. I'm just going to try and move forward a tiny bit where we can maybe see her in the infrared as well. This is very exciting now. This is very cool because we are on nature's schedule out here. So just go to where we can probably see her in the IR as well. I think, how's that, Vim? She's so well hidden in that grass. Now she's in there somewhere. Oh no. Okay, so there we go. You can just see her there on the thermal cam, on the FLIR. Looks like she's put her head down a little bit. You can see it looks like some topi in the distance as well. And she is very hungry. There's a mouse running past the impala. Avery is wondering, what time is it here? It is 8:30 in the evening. So, in 8:30. I thought she was going to actually just charge in there, but what's happened is the wind has died down a little bit. James says it's great to have the thermal cam again. Excellent stuff. Indeed it is excellent stuff. Liam and I are very excited to take this out with us on our all-night adventures. It's amazing how well camouflaged she is. And how patient she is. So that's exactly where she is. Now we've seen her on the thermal cam. And she's right there in that little thick patch of grass. Come on, girlie, go get some dinner. So we're just waiting for her to get moving again. She stalked up, I think, as close as she can. I'm trying to see if there's... And she got quite close before she went flat in the grass. Well, she's definitely not flat. She's very much heads up there, the impala. Kirsten is wondering, how far is she from the impala? Ooh. What do you think, Vim? 40 meters?
Yeah, next.
40. So she probably wants to be within about 30 or 20 preferably, before she makes her charge. But on such a dark night, and it is truly a really dark night, she might risk it from a bit further. So we're just patiently waiting for her to stalk forward a little bit. Jerry is wondering, do impala have good night vision? Well, certainly better than ours, Jerry, but not like a lion's. So they don't have the greatest night vision, but impala will rely on a lot of other things. Their hearing, if they hear something that sounds slightly suspicious, it could get them very, very alert, and they are able to disappear quite quickly. And they are very fleet of foot, and they can also leap exceedingly long distances, sort of up to 9 meters in a single leap when they have to escape something like a big hungry lioness. Oh, let's see if our girl's moved. No, she hasn't. As I said, she is quite hungry. And very, very empty belly. Oh, there we go. She head's focused on the impala again. Well, she's probably about 20, 30 meters from us. The impala, probably about 50 meters from us. She's a little bit closer to the impala than we are. Remember, this is 100% live, and we can't rush Mother Nature, but it is definitely worth sticking with us, and you never know what's going to happen next out here. Beth says, goodness, she's patient. Well, Beth, she, judging by her empty tummy, she might have missed a few other opportunities, and she is now trying to make sure she doesn't make a mistake on this stalk. But when we first were with her, the wind was very strong. Okay. Now she's focused, she's locked in on those impala. And so it's just that, looks like there's just that little bit of too much open ground that is making her worry a bit. Oh, she might be waiting for these impala to settle down properly before she goes. Has she moved them? No, she hasn't. She's right on the edge of the long grass. Infrared, and we still haven't been able to, even though we know exactly where she is, we still haven't been able to get a really clear shot of her. She's there, right there somewhere. Krista says the impala are smart, all out in the open, facing different directions. Yes, indeed they are, and a lot of animals will choose when they do rest, especially the ruminants, because they can keep eating throughout the night by chewing cud, to rest out in open areas where they've got a better chance of seeing the predators coming. From our girl. Hey, that's her there, I think, them. is in there. My yank is wondering, why are the other females from the Pride not helping her? Well, it could be that she's been off mating, and she hasn't been with her Pride for a few days. They might have been separated in a hunt. They might have been separated by marauding males. And there's lots of different reasons why they might not be together. Now, maybe the ones that we heard calling a little... Oh, there we go, she's yawning, look like... The one I heard calling a little bit earlier might be part of her Pride, not far from here. But of course she's quite hungry and she's very close to some potential dinner. So she doesn't want to talk back to the rest of her Pride, when she wants to give away her position. Says she couldn't imagine that prey being able to sleep here, because you never know what predator is hiding in the tall grass. That indeed is true. Oh, does she bunch up there a bit? Her head's up. There we go. There she's going. She's getting closer now. There we go, there go the impala. Oh, smart impala out in the open. And a lucky lady. And there you go, you can see how hungry she is. Now the impala haven't gone far. They might not. And now it's pitch black and it's a very dark night. But they're on her. She has failed. They didn't even snort. There we go, now they start snorting. Oh dear. Well, that was very, very close. But remember, throughout this all-night adventure, we will be coming to you live when action is about to happen. And unfortunately for this Mogoro girl, no dinner for her. But I'm going to stick with her, see if she meets up with the rest of the Pride, or maybe she starts hunting again. So keep a lookout for us going live throughout the night. Bye.